There are new criminal charges tonight in the killing of George Floyd. The death of the Minneapolis man at the hands of police has roiled the nation, and large-scale protests are continuing. Lisa Desjardins begins our coverage.
In Minnesota, the family of George Floyd, gathered on the eve of his memorial service, again learned news in his case. Today, the charge against Derek Chauvin, the officer who pressed his knee on Floyd's neck, was raised to second-degree murder. The three other officers who watched and stood near as Floyd died have been charged with aiding and abetting murder. Floyd family attorney Benjamin Crump.
The family has always wanted first-degree murder. They wanted him charged to the full extent of the law. Whatever George Floyd would have been charged with had the roles been reversed, that's what the families have asked for.
Crump said there is still the possibility of increased charges. Minnesota Attorney General Keith Ellison announced the decision earlier.
These charges are based on the facts that we have found, and we're going to pursue them.
It came after a night of some of the largest and largely peaceful nationwide protests yet. In New York, protesters defied a new, earlier curfew, with thousands flooding the street well into the night, with only scattered looting.
I don't preach violence, I preach equality. I want all of us to be equal, and that's why I stand.
Ultimately, police officers began pushing people off the streets.
Keep going.
Igniting a few clashes.
They grabbed innocent people for no reason and just started, like, cuffing them, pushing them to the ground. This dude was he's a journalist and a press. He has a press pass, and they pushed him to the ground.
In Washington, D.C., the scene outside the White House was also starkly different from one night earlier. A new tall fence barred protesters from Lafayette Park next to the White House. The crowd remained large and broke curfew to gather, but police did not use force to remove them, and things remained peaceful. Protesters pointedly worked to block anyone attempting violence.
There hasn't been any violence aside from a street sign that was torn down. And the crowd booed him because that's not what we're here for.
White House Press Secretary Kayleigh McEnany today raised concern about police officers who have been injured, including David Dorn, a retired officer who was killed in St. Louis while trying to protect a friend's store. President Trump had demanded that governors and mayors get tougher and use the National Guard. Today, in a Fox News radio interview, he claimed credit for things appearing to get calmer.
If you look at what happened in Minnesota, they were getting decimated, and after 3 days of watching it, I demanded that the National Guard be utilized, and in one day, it was over.
The president also talked this week of invoking the Insurrection Act to use the active duty military in a bid to restore order. But today, Secretary of Defense Mark Esper told Congress he opposes taking that step now.
The option to use active duty forces in a law enforcement role should only be used as a matter of last resort and only in the most urgent and dire of situations. We are not in one of those situations now. I do not support invoking the Insurrection Act.
Secretary Esper also defended his Monday night walk with Trump to a nearby church for a presidential photo op after police forcibly cleared away peaceful protesters.
What I was not aware of was exactly where we were going when we arrived at the church and what the plans were once we got there. It was also my aim and General Milley's to meet with and thank the members of the National Guard who were on duty that evening in the park.
But Senate Minority Leader Chuck Schumer again criticized what happened outside the White House that night.
This administration ordered federal officers to gas peaceful protesters and charge on horseback and defend our monuments like battlefield positions. What is President Trump doing to this grand democracy?
The White House and Pentagon today denied that tear gas was used on the protesters Monday night. The White House said that Attorney General Barr gave the order to push back the crowds, and it was part of a previously made decision. Meantime, the world is watching the unrest across the United States. In Iran, Supreme Leader Ayatollah Khamenei said the U.S. is hypocritical.
They kill people, committing crimes openly, and they don't apologize. But they shamelessly keep talking about human rights. Apparently, the African-American man who was killed there was not a human being.
In China, the Communist Party newspaper Global Times said the U.S. show of force proved Beijing was right to crack down on pro-democracy crowds in Tiananmen Square 31 years ago tomorrow. The tragedy of George Floyd's death has sparked global protests in solidarity against racism from London to Paris to Cape Town, South Africa. Back in the U.S., new protests flared up across cities this evening for a ninth straight night of unrest. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Lisa Desjardins.
This evening, former President Jimmy Carter released a statement calling for justice and acknowledging the pain of racism. He wrote, "We all must shine a spotlight on the immorality of racial discrimination. But violence, whether spontaneous or consciously incited, is not a solution."